Hello, welcome to Chapter 33, Bootstrap Alert, brought to you by AngPro Technologies. My name is Harish. In this session, we will be learning like how to work with Bootstrap Alert plugin. Right now, let's understand that very clearly. Keep in mind, creating a Bootstrap Alert, it's very easy when compared to other plugins. So, here is a list of classes. Using these set of classes, we can create a Bootstrap Alert. The basic class is Alert. It is used to create the alert window. And these four classes, Alert Danger, Success, Info, and Warning, they represent the contextual classes and they apply the style based on the context. Okay, and as of now, without wasting much time, let me jump into Visual Studio and let me show you how to create a Bootstrap Alert. Okay, and this is an empty web project. To this empty web project, I've added a reference of Bootstrap as well as jQuery. Right now, let me start working on Bootstrap Alert. So let me take a div. To this div element, let me add a class Alert, and let me add one contextual class Alert Danger, and let me take a bold tag, and let me add something like error, and coming out of that, let me tell like image error is something like image cannot be uploaded. Control S. When I go back, when I refresh, you can observe we are getting alert window telling like error, image cannot be uploaded. But keep in mind, how can I dismiss or how can I close this alert window? Right now we don't have any close symbol into symbol here. How can I get that? It's very simple. What I need to do is I need to take an anchor tag. To this anchor tag, I need to add few characters which gives me, okay, that is not dollar, it is ampersand, which gives me this into symbol. And also I need to set few things here. I need to set a data dash attribute called data toggle or data dismiss, sorry, data dismiss to alert. And also I need to add a class to get that into symbol, that is class close. Control S. When I go back, when I refresh, you can observe with the alert window we are getting a into mark button. Now as soon as I click on this, the alert window is disappearing. Why? Because of this data dash attribute, data dismiss is equal to alert. Okay, but keep in mind, we should get this alert window, okay, alert, Bootstrap Alert, only when we perform some task. For example, if I have a button called upload, as soon as I click on that button, I should get this alert telling like error, image cannot be uploaded. Right now we'll achieve that. Okay, before that I need to do one thing. What is that? In the sense, this alert is coming as soon as I refresh the page or push this page to the browser. So what I need to do is I need to hide this first. How can I hide it? It's very simple. I can hide that alert by adding a class called collapse. Control S. Now when I go back and when I refresh, you can observe right now we are not getting any alert because we have added a class called collapse. Okay, now our objective is we need to add a button. On click of that button, we need to get this alert. So button name is upload, and let me add some of the button classes to make it stylish. Button primary, and now control S, and let me go back and let me refresh. Currently I'm having a button. On click of this button, I need to get that alert window telling like error, image cannot be uploaded. How can I do that? It's very simple. We can achieve that by writing a bit of JavaScript. So at the end of my web page, before the body, I'll add a script tag. To that script, I need to tell like what type of script I'm writing. Type is text bar JavaScript. And here I need to write a bit of jQuery. Document dot ready, execute a function. What this function has to do, this jQuery has to do is, it has to identify this button and execute this div. This is this alert. So how can I identify this button? I can identify this button with the help of ID. ID is btn upload. Let me give ID as btn upload. And similarly to this div, let me give a ID as, it's text, or let me give it as alert text as ID. Now to the button and div, we have added the ID. So let me make use of those IDs to identify them. So what I'll do to my jQuery, I'll tell like identify the button with that ID what it is having. The ID is button upload. So my jQuery code is identifying this button with this ID. Once it is identified, I have to attach a click event. On click of that, this alert should come. So click, okay, click event, and the click event I need to execute one function. What that function is going to do is that function is going to execute this alert window. So how can I identify this alert which is present inside the due? I can identify that alert present inside the due by this ID. ID is alert text. Okay, let me copy this, control C, and I have to attach to that click event telling like, okay, I've identified that. Then once you identified that alert window, just show it. Okay, just show it, and it also later let me show you what are the values it's going to take. Now when I do control S, when I go back, when I refresh, now when I click on this upload, you can observe I'm getting an error alert window telling like error, image cannot be uploaded. Right now let me push that message down by adding a bit of break lines. When I go back, when I refresh, when I click on this button, you can observe we are getting alert telling like error, image cannot be uploaded. Let me refresh it again. Now you can observe when I click on this, that alert window comes very soon. Now if I need to do some animation, what I can do is I need to pass a value to this show method telling like fade. What is this fade going to do? It brings the alert window with the animation, you can observe. Okay, control S, when I go back, when I refresh, now when I click on this upload, you can observe we're getting this error alert window with the animation effect. Again when I click on this, it's gone. When I refresh it, you can observe like we're getting this alert window with the animation. This is what we done right now, like we learned like how to get the alert window on click of a button using this jQuery code. But you can observe very clearly now as soon as I refresh this page, now when I click on this upload button, we are getting this alert window for sure. But as soon as I close this, and again when I click on this upload button, we are not getting that alert. Okay, how can we achieve that? Okay, in a sense, how can we solve that? We can solve that by first removing this data dash attribute attached to this anchor tag. Okay, then I have to attach an ID to this telling like close link. Okay, then I have to write a bit of jQuery to that also telling like currently what's happening here. Now as soon as I click this, I'm getting this alert window, but when I close this button, what's happening right now? Okay, let me show you with that data dash attribute what happened. Control S, when I go back, when I refresh, when I click on this upload button, we are getting this alert. And when I click on this, what's happening right now is that alert window is removed from the DOM. So we are not getting it back as soon as I click it again. So how can I solve that? I can solve that by removing this data dismiss attribute. And again, we need to add an ID called close link. Now what I need to do is I need to rewrite a bit of jQuery telling like, okay, when someone click on this anchor link, okay, identify it by this ID, control C, control V, then don't remove this text from the DOM. Instead of that, you just hide it. Okay, when I do control S, when I go back and when I refresh, you can observe when I click on this, I'm getting this alert window, and I'll close this, and again when I click on that, I'm getting back. Why? Because right now what we are doing, instead of removing it from the DOM, we are just hiding that text, so we are getting it. Okay, and also we can tell like, okay, we can tell like let me show you. Currently when I refresh the page, when I click it, this error message, this alert window, it will not disappear until and unless when I click on this button, it will stay forever. So what I need to do is I need to set a timeout. So suppose the user does not click on this close button, this error message or alert window has to disappear by itself. So how to set the timeout? It's very simple. Here I have to commit, and I have to tell like call anonymous function set timeout. Okay, what I need to do is I need to call a function to this function. I have to tell like, okay, control C, Okay, now I have to hide it. Hide it when after 2 milliseconds. Control S. When I go back, when I refresh, now when I click on this, now I'll not close this. Now you observe after 2 seconds. Okay, it's disappearing by itself. You can observe after 2 seconds it's disappearing by itself, and also before 2 seconds if I close, the alert window will disappear. Okay, right now in this session we learned like the how to work with the alert window and how to make the alert window should come when I click on the button, and also we learned like how to set the timeout, and also we learned the beautiful demo of how to build alert window, and we also learned the advanced of jQuery here. Okay, and this is what we learned in this session, and we also saw a beautiful demo. And finally, thank you for listening. Have a great day. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel AngPro Training. You can also like our Facebook page visiting these URLs. You can also follow us on Twitter for further references, refer our websites. We are on LinkedIn too. Last but not the least, please don't forget to give the feedback. Thank you. Have a great day.